Bragging rights in New York area soccer are on the line, and the road goes through Red Bull Arena. Welcome into the Lamar Hunt U.S. Open Cup round of 16. It's on the line for regional supremacy tonight. New York City FC has been eliminated. We have red and green, the New York Red Bulls and the New York Cosmos battling it out tonight from Red Bull Arena. The winner goes on to the quarterfinals to face Philadelphia. The loser's Open Cup dream is done for this season. Good evening, everybody. Welcome into this YouTube stream brought to you by U.S. Soccer. I'm Jonathan Yardley alongside David Goss. And Dave, we live in the New York area. We've heard about all three teams, red, blue, green, all year long. The Cosmos took care of New York City FC at the shootout win in the fourth round of the Open Cup. The Red Bulls took care of them twice in the regular season. So this is for number one in the metropolitan area tonight.
Yeah, the crown sits here, and there's that little extra bit to this game because of what happened last year already. And so these two teams, unlike with NYCFC, already know each other. They already don't like each other. And that's just going to make it even more fun. A taste of revenge for the Red Bulls and for the Cosmos. They want this last opportunity to say that they're the kings of New York.
The New York Cosmos out of the North American Soccer League, 5-0-5 in the spring season to win the NASL's spring title. They have done this against Major League Soccer teams before, only in their third season now. The rebranded New York Cosmos. Last year, they beat the Red Bulls, as David mentioned, emphatically, 3-0 out on Long Island. Then they went down to Philadelphia in the U.S. Open Cup, took the Union to overtime, a little bit of a harsh luck loser to that game. So they feel like they can compete with the big boys. And Dave, they have some big names on their roster, players with MLS experience, with Red Bulls experience, and a couple guys with some world-class experience as well.
Some European championships, Champions League as well on that roster. But the familiarity between the former Cosmos players on the Red Bulls, the former Red Bull players on the Cosmos, just adds another, like you need another one, another spice to this game. Carlos Mendes leading his team out. The second time he will face off against the club in MLS that he represented for so long.
Great ties between these teams. And they will go head-to-head. Dax McCarty called last year's loss embarrassing. He wasn't on the field, he was in the stands, but it clearly means something, and we're gonna get to the starting lineup shortly. Both teams fielding very strong lineups. It's gonna be the Red Bulls' best against the Cosmos' best tonight.
For so long, we've asked to see this competition grow. These two teams taking it as seriously as they can. They want to win. These fans are here, out. They don't like each other already. There's a lot of energy in this building. This is going to be one of the best U.S. Open Cup games we've seen.
We'll listen in for the national anthem, and then we'll get you ready for play. The Red Bulls and the Cosmos in the Open Cup. Thank you. great rendition of our national anthem, and that gets us just about ready for soccer. The New York Red Bulls tied for third in Major League Soccer's Eastern Conference. The New York Cosmos, spring champions of the North American Soccer League. And here is the starting lineup for the Cosmos. Jimmy Maurer in goal, Hunter Freeman, Hunter Gorski, Carlos Mendez. Three of those four former Red Bulls players. It'll be a 4-2-3-1 with Zatella and Senna sitting behind. We expect an attacking trio of Restrepo, Flores, and Fernandez, all behind Lucky Cassano. That means David Raul starts on the bench.
Which is a curveball, but when you look at this team, Jimmy Maurer, Hunter Gorski, Carlos Mendez, two center backs and goalkeeper have played every single minute of this NASL season together. They gave up 9 goals in 10 games, so this is a defensive unit that's as solid as it gets.
For the New York Red Bulls, around any game like this, you wonder what kind of a lineup is the MLS team throwing out. New York is playing 3 games in 7 days. It's starters. Duvall, Perenel, Miazga, Lade is in there in place of Kemar Lawrence. Sean Davis spells Felipe. Sal Zizo and Lloyd Sam spell Bradley Wright Phillips and Mike Grella. But we've seen all of these guys start regularly for the Red Bull.
This is as talented a lineup as I think they could put out. You look at this team and you see Matt Miazga. Every time this team has won so far this season, he has been in the lineup. Anatole Bonk has forced his way into the lineup. And Sean Davis filled in well for Sasha Kljestan last week in the midweek, and then in the U.S. Open Cup round, last round against Atlanta, got himself his first professional goal. So this is a very strong New York Red Bulls team. The only question is heavy legs coming off a lot of games over the last 2 weeks.
Jesse Marsh said, "We want to emerge as the leaders in New York soccer. And that means winning tomorrow." That was after Red Bulls training yesterday. And it's true, because you lose this, you don't get a chance to beat the Cosmos again for a year. And for the Cosmos, likewise, you lose here, you don't get another crack at an MLS team for a full year. So it's a little bit more than just your average Open Cup round of 16 games.
And you talked about Dax McCarty's comments. You can see the taste on guys like him and Luis Robles, who didn't get the chance to play in this game last year and were not happy with the way it went. And like you said, with no league rematches, this is it. This is your one opportunity to play against each other. I love what you're hearing from the coaches, that they're just coming out and admitting it. It's a big game. This is a rivalry. This is an exciting matchup. Don't hide it. Put out your best players, and you're going to really see two teams push each other. You're going to see some great energy on the field.
The Red Bulls will be in white. The Cosmos will be in blue. I prefer red against green, but those are the uniform assignments for tonight. Luis Robles was so fired up on Sunday at Yankee Stadium. I've never seen him so pumped, even after the Red Bulls won the Supporters' Shield 2 years ago. We'll see how New York maintains its intensity today. Jesse Marsh, of course, in his first year coaching the Red Bulls, and on the other sideline, Giovanni Savarese, one of the early legends for the Metro Stars, later worked for the Metro Stars and the New York Red Bulls in coaching. Now he's coaching at the highest level, gets his second chance against them tonight.
Scored the first goal in this club's history, never had a chance to play in this building, now gets to lead an opponent in here and try and knock this team off again.
Kickoff from Red Bull Arena. Red Bulls, Cosmos, the sequel, the 2015 edition, underway in the Lamar Hunt U.S. Open Cup. The winner goes on to the quarterfinals to take on the Philadelphia Union. The loser returns their focus to league play, and league play only for the rest of the year.
Early on, you look at this New York Red Bull squad. Lloyd Sam back from that injury. He's going to come in one of the few guys that's going to have fresh legs, even though he's coming off an injury. And he's such a huge threat for this team. Got a goal in the last U.S. Open Cup game in just his 20 minutes of action, and he's going to be a danger man today.
He gets it to Chris Duvall here, looking early. Anatole Bong defended out by Caceres, and it'll be a corner kick for the Red Bulls right off the bat.
And you see early on, Lloyd Sam able to suck in a fullback, play Duvall down the line. Chris Duvall coming off his first goal of his professional career in the last game against NYCFC. Got a red card in this matchup last year, so he's going to have to watch the emotions.
Already our official Ted Uncle wants a word with the players in the box. Paul Scott, James Conley, the assistants, Justin Lopez, the fourth official tonight. Sal Zizo to deliver the corner. Goes low, it's dummied for Kljestan over the top. I saw the Red Bulls work on that at training yesterday, and the first attempt, it looked just like that. The second one, they got it right, but come game day, it's over the top.
And we know this New York Red Bulls team is going to come out. They're going to press high. They have a strong back line, and so they can feel comfortable pushing high and allowing their defenders to defend one-on-one.
Here is Luis Robles with a touch, pressured by Lucky Cassana. This is Marco Senna on the ball. Last year wasn't healthy enough to play. This year he's good to go in terms of the Open Cup, that is.
And this New York Cosmos team hasn't played since they played that NYCFC U.S. Open Cup matchup. The NASL spring season has finished. They've had this 2 weeks off before they start the fall season next week. So these players were able to rest. And the question coming into these opening minutes is, will they look rested and energetic, or will they look a little bit rusty? For the New York Red Bulls team, they should come out strong. They're fit. They're sharp right now. They've been playing at a high level over the last 2 weeks. The question is, later in the game, will they have legs?
Falls to Restrepo. One-on-one against Connor Lade. Gets a step on him. And the Red Bulls are able to clear. You mentioned, David, the consistency at the back for the Cosmos, but with Samuel Caceres slotting in on the back line, it's moved Hunter Gorski out wide left, where he has played before, but this exact back four in these positions has not spent that much time together.
And they have a few different defensive pieces that they can use. Hunter Freeman hurt this season, so different guys got experience at different positions. But like you said, Gorski has played left back before, so there is that familiarity for him personally, and it's just a little bit of communication. But this is a squad that, when you look at that back six, has been together over the past 2 years or so, and so they've really, Marcus Senna and Zatella as well, gotten to know each other.
Anatole Labong into the penalty area. Jimmy Maurer comes out and smothers it for the Cosmos.
And Anatole Labong, an 18-year-old, coming into this team for the first time. You see the confidence he has. He hasn't pushed Bradley Wright Phillips out of this team at all, but he's moved his position, a guy who's a DP striker, because they just need to have him on the field, and he's playing with a lot of confidence.
Lloyd Sam has a wide open Salzizo, and he puts the Red Bulls in front. It only took him 5 minutes, and in form, the Red Bulls off to the perfect start.
And we saw an early threat from New York with the first cross coming from Chris Duvall, and another opportunity here to get down that right side. That ball curled in. Hunter Freeman nowhere near Salzizo. Lloyd Sam showing why he's so important to this team, and he stands it up perfectly to allow Zizo to get under it, and he buries it to the far post for the first goal against the Cosmos for this New York Red Bulls team.
Salzizo missed almost 2 months of action earlier this year. Gets his first goal, and a big one, to get the Red Bulls off to a perfect start. And they're looking for more. Question to a bong straight up the gut. And Carlos Mendes knocks it away.
And it looks like this New York Red Bulls team coming out sharp. We said it, the Cosmos coming off a few weeks of rest. Haven't played. Maybe a little bit of rust there. We've seen chances already both sides. Only 5 minutes in. This should be an open game throughout.
Last year, the New York Cosmos struck in the 7th minute to take control against an undermanned Red Bulls team out on Long Island. This year, it's 5 minutes in for the Red Bulls to take the lead. Sam will bring this back out for Kleshton. He was offside. And it'll be a free kick for the Cosmos at the back.
And if you're the Cosmos, you don't panic. You just stick to your game plan here. That early goal, you have to keep your head down. Do what you got you here. And don't lose your game plan at all so early on in a game.
New York City FC got the first goal and the second goal against the Cosmos in their fourth round matchup 2 weeks ago. The Cosmos rallied late in that one. They won't have the home fans to back them tonight, but they do have some hearty support in green up at the north end of Red Bull Arena. There's Damian Perrinel. Came off the bench in Sunday's win over New York City FC. Back in the starting lineup with Ronald Zubar, dealing with more nagging injuries. There's Hunter Freeman, one of those former Red Bulls, now wearing the Cosmos colors, and he was so influential in that comeback against New York City FC. Played a big role in setting up both goals. One from Leo Fernandez, one from Lucky Cassana, to tie that game 2-2, and again, the Cosmos eventually won it in a shootout. The Red Bulls got here with a convincing 3-0 win over the Atlanta Silverbacks in this facility.
And that game was the start of them proving how much they take this competition seriously. Strong lineup in that game, a strong win, like you said, coming out here again, showing they want to win trophies, they want to add to this club's legacy, and this is a great opportunity to do it.
Here is Cassana, banging it long in the direction of Leo Fernandez. Chris Duvall out to meet him. Fernandez gets some space, gets the cross in. Restrepo from a bad angle. His shot was blocked by Lade. Dax McCarty able to clear halfway. Marco Senna from distance up into the south ward. But a positive response from the New York Cosmos, showing how they can be dangerous in this game.
And the Cosmos, with this three-man front line, choosing to keep bodies high. Restrepo and Fernandez and Cassano not dropping deep defensively. And so they're consistently going to be a threat on the counter. And we talked about how important Hunter Freeman was in the comeback against NYCFC in their last U.S. Open Cup game. But Cassano, his physical ability, his ability to battle with defenders in the middle of the field but still have the skill and composure to finish, was a huge part of that game. And they were consistently, he was consistently able to battle with the center backs, occupy those center backs, allow for his wingers to create, and then get, finally, in the 90th minute, get on the finishing touch of it.
Cassana the target here. He gets a touch but can't bring the ball down. And it'll be a goal kick for the Red Bulls.
And a little bit of what I'm talking about. Great target man, can drop deep and create, but such a great physical presence up top to battle with those center backs, and also his speed over the top.
Luis Robles has played every game this year for the Red Bulls. He, Dax McCarty, and Felipe had started every game, including that Open Cup game against Atlanta. So Felipe gets the night off from a starting perspective, is available off the bench. Here's Zizo, the goal scorer, against Hunter Freeman. Great pass to find Sean Davis. And Abong was onside, but couldn't bring the ball down.
Similar work from Matt Miazga, what we saw over the weekend against David Villa. When this whole team pushes high, sometimes getting stuck on an island, that ability to battle, to win that first ball, allow his team to get back into a defensive position.
Good vision by Senna to get that wide for Restrepo. Dancing against two, he tries to split them, still battling with Lade. Again, Lade was on loan to the Cosmos in the second half of last season. Restrepo wasn't with the team then, and Restrepo gets the best of him here, gets a free kick, and gets Connor Lade a yellow card in just the 11th minute. Bit of a surprise to see the early yellow.
And a little unfortunate for Lade. I think the ref played through the initial foul, and so he kind of gives that yellow card for persistent infringement, even though we're only 10 minutes into this game throughout that one play. Restrepo has stayed wide the entire game, hugging that touchline, and so he's going to get one-on-one opportunities consistently with Lade. Lade has to be careful with that yellow card, and he has to get some help from his midfield and not get stuck on an island.
Hunter Freeman with the restart. Just like the Red Bulls, the Cosmos were trying something from the training ground, and just like at the other end of the field, it doesn't come off. Zizo, great long ball. Maurer was well out, and he'll use his comfortable left foot to play that one out for a throw.
Read very well there by Jimmy Maurer. He has been immense for this team since coming in and replacing Kyle Ranish.
Reminder, you can follow U.S. Soccer's coverage of the Lamar Hunt U.S. Open Cup on Twitter using the handle @OpenCup. Three other games going on tonight. Four quarterfinalists determined yesterday. The other four finding out when and where they will be playing. If they get through tonight's game, all of those assignments will be posted tomorrow.
And as usual, yesterday, a wild day of Open Cup play. It seems like every round, this competition just gets crazier and crazier.
Here's a look back at Sal Zizzo. He scored the goal, and he was looking for two.
Zizzo playing with confidence. When he came back into this team 2 weeks ago, right off his injury, Jesse Marsh said that this team hadn't lost with him on the field. He values him a lot for what he brings, intangibles. Not normally his goal scoring, his ability to stretch the field, to open up play, to read the run well.
Well, what, he earned a penalty kick within 5 minutes of coming back into the lineup? It wasn't his fault they didn't convert, as Dax McCarty fires that one over the top.
McCarty a little upset with himself after that one. Saw Marco Senna hit one high earlier. These two teams fired up to start this game, no surprise, and you see a little bit of what Anatole Abang brings to this team. Back to goal, strength, athleticism. Sets up McCarty perfectly there, just couldn't get it on frame.
Great atmosphere inside Red Bull Arena tonight. I, for one, fought the traffic getting here, and I think there's some people still out there doing likewise, but it's going to be a good night for New York area soccer. Red in most of the building, but again, green off to our left, up above Jimmy Maurer. You're probably not going to be able to see it in most of the shots because they're in the upper level here. But we know in the vicinity of 500 fans were expected to make the trip, and I dare say it has exceeded that.
Yeah, green dotted throughout the stadium. Great opportunity for the Cosmos fans to come to this beautiful soccer facility. A little bit of a new challenge for them. This is now the third time they're playing in what you could say is this New York City soccer triangle, but the first time on the road. They hosted the Red Bulls last year. They hosted NYCFC earlier in this competition, so now an opportunity to prove they can do it on the road.
First competitive Cosmos game in New Jersey since 1984. Of course, they called Giant Stadium home for so many years. Chris Duvall on the overlap after Sam left it. Abang making the run. Unclear whether he was onside or not, but we're going to play through it.
And Duvall just has to be a little bit more composed there. He doesn't have to rush that.
Great ball with Jimmy Maurer's off foot, and it sets up a 3-on-2. Restrepo tried to feed Cassano, it falls to him anyway. He's onside, and he's tied the game. Lucky Cassano, lucky on the spot. 1-1 in Harrison.
And Jimmy Maurer here went down, played for a year in Chile, said that his distribution got so much better there because of their style of play. Restrepo, we've seen be a threat all game. Loves to get his defender on the back. The early pass there, but Cassano able to stay in line with Miazga when he's on the ground. And he gives you that physical ability to battle, but also that finishing composure. He had the game-tying goal in the last one against NYCFC, and the Cosmos, credit to them, did not panic after going down early on the road and come back once again and get the tie here so far.
Lucky Cassano, 3 goals in NASL play. 1 in the Open Cup, gets his second today. And of course, he had a couple more in Cuba in that friendly the Cosmos played as well. Having a great year for the Cosmos and has us all even once again.
And he loves to play this New York Red Bulls team. Had 2 goals for the Harrisburg City Islanders in this competition, including a winner in extra time a couple of years back. He wasn't starting to start the year for the Cosmos. He's worked his way into the lineup, even with the bigger, more famous names around him, and you can see why. He just brings so many different tools to the table.
One part of this game that's probably not going to come through on the stream, and it's a shame, we have 5 broadcasts here tonight. One of them should have dedicated a camera to Gio Savarese, because he is an act in and of himself on the sideline for the Cosmos.
He was a passionate player, and he's brought that to the sideline this is a big game for his club. This is a big game for his league that he represents, and he is out here giving it his all, and I think that goes through to the players a little bit.
I'm sure Red Bulls fans were watching that play looking for offside, which was Luis Robles' first reaction as well. He looked right at the linesman, Paul Scott, who confirmed that Kasana stayed on, as David said, even with Matt Miazga on the play. It was a little tricky because Miazga actually played it and it hit off of Fernandez, but I think onside was the right call. And it has the Cosmos level with the Red Bulls early in this one.
And you go back to the fact that Cristobal hit that early cross as the team was transitioning from defense to offense to start that play, and Jimmy Maurer, a great play from him to keep it alive and get that ball back in.
Sam looking back post, and again Zizo got the best of Freeman but couldn't direct this one into a threatening look.
That's why the Red Bulls, when they are transitioning like that, you have to wait for your numbers to get settled a little bit so you don't get caught on that quick counterattack.
Jonathan Yardley, David Goss with you from Red Bull Arena. The New York Red Bulls from Major League Soccer at home in white and red tonight. The New York Cosmos from the North American Soccer League in all blue, trying to be the only lower division team to advance to the quarterfinals. And Ted Uncle is going to go back and retroactively give a yellow card to Walter Restrepo for a tackle on the near sideline.
He took out Connor Lade earlier, about 2 minutes ago at this point. Great memory from him. Of course, it's his job. He comes back and gives that yellow card. So now both Connor Lade and Restrepo down that wing have a yellow.
Cosmos fans making more noise and their team trying to follow suit at the moment, but Perenelle able to get it away for the Red Bulls. The South Ward noise level had died out right at that moment. We could hear the Borough Boys from off to our left just as the Cosmos went looking for the go-ahead goal.
And they are used to this team this season falling behind in games, but they went undefeated in that spring season in ASL. They consistently fight back. This team has a lot of confidence in their abilities, and they really never drop their head and give up, even when they're down two goals late in the game.
Restrepo's been giving late fits, but he ran out of room there. Sean Davis couldn't handle that one. He's had a quiet day so far, hasn't really gotten involved. Cosmos with it again on the front foot. Here's Restrepo. Perenelle out to meet him. Sasha Kleschen broke that one up. Lade gets it back to him. But Danny Zatella, New Jersey native, won it back for the Cosmos.
And that's one of the fun parts about this game. A lot of local flavor. A lot of players that grew up in this tri-state area playing in this game here, as well as players who played in college in the area or professionally at times now.
Well, Danny Zatella started his comeback in the Open Cup with Icon FC and went on to earn a spot with the Cosmos. Reminder, the New York Red Bulls return home in MLS action on Saturday, July 11th, 7 o'clock, as Eastern Conference rival New England Revolution come to Red Bull Arena. For tickets and more information, go to newyorkredbulls.com or call 877-727-6223 today. Red Bulls will be in action at Columbus this weekend for the 4th of July. Home, as we mentioned, against New England on July 11th, and a busy late July for the Red Bulls, which of course has everybody wondering when their quarterfinal would be played if they were to advance, but let's be honest, that's a problem for tomorrow morning. Right now, the New York Cosmos are intent on setting up a matchup against Philadelphia, one which the Union would host because the Cosmos' main stadium's unavailable that day. Driven switch for Restrepo with Freeman overlapping. Hesitated, but got it to Kasana. Trying to turn, and Cristobal clears. This is Gorski stepping forward. He's going to hit it well off the mark from the left back.
This Cosmos team, it may be tough to see from home, but they leave their three attackers up the field and spread out at all times, even when their team is back defending. And so they constantly have a counterattack outlet to go to, either down the wings or up the middle to Cassano. And whenever they get the ball up the field, they have numbers to play with. They don't have to wait for the rest of the team to attack. It can be dangerous if you get stuck in numbers defensively with the Red Bulls pushing forward. But at the same time, since they've scored this goal, they've been able to get the numbers forward, and they're consistently able to get an attack.
Kleschen and McCarty combining. Here is Sasha Kleschen. Sam outside of him. Lloyd Sam to the end line. Cross was blocked by Gorski. Out for the New York Red Bulls. Third corner kick of this first half.
Red Bulls, has to keep going to the wings. There's not a lot of space in the middle. Zatella and Senna close up that space well. But like we said, the wingers for this Cosmos team are not dropping deep to defend. And so you're going to get one-on-one opportunities with Sam and with Zizzo on the other side, and you have to go to them.
Kleschen's corner, headed over the top by Davis. There was a lot of contact. Players from both teams, I think, thought a foul was going to be called. None came. And Sean Davis got the final touch.
This one driven in. Matt Miazga ends up on the ground, it looks like, as does Carlos Mendez. Neither team's really been that successful with any of their set pieces so far in this game.
You see Miazga, still only 19, like Danny Zatella from Clifton, New Jersey, in Passaic County, just a little ways from here, playing on a big stage tonight.
And what a turnaround for him. A year ago, he was trying to get himself into this first team and had the opportunity to start against the Cosmos, one of his very first professional soccer starts. Now a year later, had played heavy minutes in the U20 World Cup, is a full-time starter in Major League Soccer and playing with a whole new level of poise.
As you mentioned before, not just a starter, an influencer. The Red Bulls splits with him in the lineup versus without him in the lineup, a huge indicator of their success. Davis growing in confidence, hits it with the left, tipped over by Maurer. It was a quiet first 20 minutes for Sean Davis, not quiet at the moment.
And Sean Davis is an attacking midfielder, and so playing in this defensive role behind Sasha Kleschen, he kind of has to curb those instincts a little bit more, but when he's going to get around the 18, that's when he's going to be successful. Last week when he was in the team, he was a like-for-like switch with Sasha Kleschen in that quote-unquote number 10 role. And so that's where Sean Davis likes to play.
Kleschen's corner loose in the penalty area, and it's off a Red Bull's hand. It'll be a free kick for the New York Cosmos coming out.
And a lot of wrestling going on between these two teams on corner kicks. Last time it was Miazga, this time it looked like Perrinel.
Mendez put in a tough spot there with Sam lurking. But the veteran did really well to keep it for the Cosmos. Here's Fernandez. Senna and Zatella, the holding midfield duo for the Cosmos. Loose touch there, and Abong couldn't get to it. And now the whistle blows, so they can get a look at Anatole Abong.
while you hate to see a player down injured, New York Red Bulls have a sub option in Bradley Wright Phillips off the bench. Rarely does he not start a game. Anatole Abang, since coming into this team, has been able to cement that center forward role for himself. Got a goal off the bench against Houston.
This is how we got here. Lloyd Sam with the cross. Sal Zizo a header in just the fifth minute to put the Red Bulls in front, mimicking the Cosmos' early goal last year.
And if New York's able to keep, excuse me, if the Red Bulls are able to stay wide offensively, they're going to get opportunities one-on-one like you see there. And if one defender falls asleep, you have a wide open target in the box.
Third straight start for Anatole Abang, the 18-year-old. Two goals and an assist in his last four games. And he walks off here. You know he wants to stay in. But for now, the Red Bulls will restart with 10.
And New York Red Bulls have some bench options in Mike Grella, in Felipe, and Bradley Wright Phillips, normally starters on the bench here today. Now, of course, the New York Cosmos have a big bench piece in Raul.
I've heard of him, I think.
Coming off, he only brings the record in Champions League goals as well as three Champions League titles and a couple Spanish national team captaincies. So there's still a lot of firepower to come in this game.
He started every regular season game for the Cosmos and was player of the month in May, actually. I have a feeling we're going to see him. He's not a guy you expect to play 120 minutes at his age. And so given the potential for this one to be decided late, to be decided in extra time, maybe not a bad idea to bring him on in the second half.
Coach Savarese got burned a little bit with that one in the last game. He got 87 minutes out of him, which he said for a 38-year-old, great production, but what didn't have him for extra time.
Restrepo to that end line again, goes low. Miazga dealt with it ahead of the charging Andres Flores, whose name we've hardly called tonight. Flores playing the role normally occupied by Raul.
And Flores floating behind those three other attackers. He stays central when Cassana goes out wide and Fernandez switches in, which we've seen a lot of movement between those two. But like you said, a quiet game. The ball's really bypassed him a lot. But he's right there if the ball gets knocked down by anyone to take that strike on the second ball.
Fans, still time to vote for your favorite New York Red Bulls player or your favorite MLS player for the 2015 AT&T MLS All-Star Game. Voting is open now, ends on July 3rd. Go to newyorkredbulls.com or mlssoccer.com to vote today. The All-Star Game will be at Dick's Sporting Goods Park just outside of Denver late this July. It's already July. How did that happen? So we're talking 4 weeks from now. Chance for New York Red to move quickly against New York Blue. I knew I was going to do that once tonight. They can't take it, and Blue, or Green, depending on how you look at it, the Cosmos go the other way.
And these two teams going toe for toe, and that's not a surprise. Coach Jesse Marsh said before the game that this Cosmos team is as good as any team that they really see, that if they played in Major League Soccer alongside them, they would be a competitive team. Of course, for the Cosmos, this is a big game. Their one opportunity to knock off a local rival as well as potentially get into the CONCACAF Champions League. They're able to win the U.S. Open Cup and add that piece of silverware. And that's what we've seen so far. Two teams opening up, not playing nervous, not playing tight, but with quality on both sides.
We told you about the Red Bulls' upcoming schedule. The Cosmos will open the NASL's fall season Sunday night out at Hofstra on Long Island against the Indy 11. Then they'll have a weekend off and continue NASL play July 18th. Freeman steps up to intercept that one.
But this season sets up well if the Cosmos can make a run in this tournament, because as spring champions, they've already qualified for their playoffs at the end of the year. And so they can kind of manage their roster if they do have midweek games going forward with U.S. Open Cup action.
A Cassana left that one for Flores, but Dax McCarty beat his opposite number, literally 11, to the ball for the Red Bulls. Good read of the spin on that one by Sean Davis, the rookie out of Duke. Has Sam. Corner of the penalty area with Kleschen coming. Pass was just a half step behind Sasha Kleschen. Zizo offside this time. Maurer denied the first shot anyway, but it was offside the whole way. And it'll just be a free kick for the Cosmos at the back.
It's incredible that Lloyd Sam's been out with this injury and has come in and looks so sharp here in this first half. Of course, the fans in this arena not happy right now with that call, the correct call though. And you saw just a flash. Jimmy Maurer hasn't had much work to do. A fantastic goalkeeper, just 26 years old, so young for a goalkeeper, but has shown his quality so far in his professional career.
He backed up Kyle Reinisch, who is now the Red Bulls backup on the Cosmos in 2013. Here's a look at the play. It's not going to be the best angle for us to tell whether Zizo was offside or not. From here, it looked like the right call. And you see it was a good save from Maurer in the end.
Now Zizo is down on the ground.
Hunter Freeman going to escape a yellow card here. As you look at jerseys past and present, Metro Stars, Red Bulls history over in the South Ward. I think there's a lot of historical jerseys here tonight. U.S. Open Cup using a fixed bracket from the round of 16 on for the first time in the modern era. Something I'm a big fan of, and it means we already know the potential path to the final for everybody in this tournament. Lade's throw-in kept things alive. Perrinell to the back post. Sam couldn't connect. It was between Abong and Zizo. Cleared halfway, but not out.
Interesting play off that throw-in, a planned play to Kleschen on the end line, flicked it back into the middle. Perrinell able to keep that one alive as the center back stays up the field in an offensive position.
You didn't have Connor Lade in the long throw-in pool?
Never would have known it.
Morristown skills right there.
Of course, our Jonathan Yardley, also a local, and I guess also has a long throw-in that he's got in his locker.
I could throw it onto the field from here. That's about it. Cassana and Perrinell jostling. Lade gets it to Kleschen on the run. Head up. Wants a bong, and Caceres able to cut it out for the Cosmos. The Paraguayan.
Anatole Abong still developing so much as a player. Such a young player. Not a lot of professional experience. Could really learn a few things from watching Cassano play. How he is aggressive with the center backs, how he initiates contact, as well as how aggressively he makes his runs rather than floating farther away from the ball. Hard cutting runs, diagonal runs to allow someone to play him through and to put pressure on the back line.
Handball against Andres Flores on that far side. Leo Fernandez into the middle of the field right now for the Cosmos. He and Flores will switch at times. Here's Zizo centrally, trying to sneak through three. He got it to Abong. He's offside. The flag is up again. James Conley alert, the far side assistant. And once again, Jimmy Maurer made the save anyway.
And you don't want to kill a play as it's developed, but for Abong, it's okay that you're running that last line, that inch, because when you do get it right, you're going to be put straight through like that. So you have to keep pushing that boundary. And of course, Carlos Mendez, a seasoned veteran, knows how to read the play, command his back line, is able to get forward and get that call. Thank you.
Restrepo against Lade. We haven't seen this battle in a few minutes. Dax McCarty comes over to help for the Red Bulls. And he's going to get whistled for the foul. He, Zizo, and their head coach, Jesse Marsh, are all up in arms. And letting Ted Uncle know they disagree with that. There's a look at Jesse Marsh.
Jesse Marsh saying they're both doing it, but Restrepo, the offensive player, is always going to get that call. Good to see McCarty, though, come over and help Lade. Don't leave Lade one-on-one with Restrepo too many times. Already has that yellow card. You don't want him to get in any more trouble. Marco Senna, as good a player as there is on this continent right now, serving set pieces in.
Sasha Kleshchen got ahead to his free kick. Gorski and Abong collide, and the throw-in goes the way of the Cosmos. Gorski left-footed cross. Perenel heads away. Zatella broke that one up, stripped Davis. Senna thinking shot first, lines one up and can't quite manage to find the top corner. He's going to turn 39 later this month. But as you said, David, he can still play.
He came in, he scored the game winner, his first season in the Soccer Bowl.
And what a game winner that was.
He has shown flashes offensively throughout his career, of course, but was always a holding, crunching tackle defensive midfielder, given a little bit more space and freedom in the NASL and with the Cosmos, and has been a set piece specialist for them, has really not blossomed, but allowed to play offensively. The guy has won everything in his career, has really done anything, set to retire at the end of the next season, but has had a great Cosmos career to go on top of the career he had at Villarreal.
We told you four games yesterday in the Open Cup. The Philadelphia Union went down to 10 men in the first half, scored two in the second, coming from behind to beat DC United 2-1. Eric Ayuk and Fabinho with the goals in that one. Philadelphia will play the winner of this game. Orlando City beat the Columbus Crew 2-0. Goals from Kaká and Carlos Rivas. We're told Adrian Heath tried to take Kaká out of the game. Kaká said no. He wanted to stay in and finish it. He made it till, I think, the 87th minute. Pretty cool there. Orlando will advance and take on Chicago. The Fire fell behind the Charlotte Independents but came back to win that one. Kleshchen plays this one through the area looking for Abong. It'll be out for a goal kick.
And Anatole Abong has to get on the end of that. You see him running side by side with the center back, but he has to read that play just a little bit quicker, get himself that extra yard so he can stretch out and challenge Jimmy Maurer on that cross ball. Once again, a cross coming in from the right is dangerous for this New York Red Bulls team. They have to continue to push it down that flank.
Reminder, ussoccer.com is your source for full coverage of the 2015 Lamar Hunt U.S. Open Cup. And you can follow coverage of the tournament on Twitter, at Open Cup. And they will tell you all about Mike McGee's two goals for the Chicago Fire, as well as Lavelle Palmer scoring. Chicago 3, Charlotte 1. So it'll be Orlando and Chicago in what they're calling the South Region. The Philadelphia Union and the winner of this game in what they're calling the East Region. And then the Houston Dynamo beat the Colorado Rapids 1-0 late last night after a weather delay in Houston. Mauro Manotas, the teenager, his first goal since joining Houston. That's in the South Region. They'll get the winner of Sporting Kansas City and FC Dallas, which means it'll be a rivalry game of sorts either way. Those teams set to start when we reach halftime. We hope you'll watch that game after our game finishes. Stick with ours till the finish. Lloyd Sam's shot blocked out. The other games later tonight, way out west, Real Salt Lake hosting the Portland Timbers and the San Jose Earthquakes hosting the LA Galaxy.
And we had some great games yesterday, and because of the weather delays, you had a couple games that were thrown off, but I watched Orlando Columbus, and there wasn't the energy and the competitiveness that you're seeing between these two teams here today. This one has been taken up to another notch for a round of 16 cup knockout game. This one has so much more meaning on it.
Kleshchen's delivery, Anatole Abong strikes again. and puts the Red Bulls in front. Boy, is the teenager hot.
Just a few weeks ago, no one knew this kid's name. He has come in and brought a presence to this New York Red Bulls 2 team. You see that power, his ability to battle against Marco Senna and Hunter Freeman, two seasoned veterans. We talked about all the attributes he brings to the field. That natural height is one of them. And he just battles through and buries that one. And this kid cannot stop scoring.
The other part of that play, who delivered it? Sasha Kljestan, two assists against New York City FC on Sunday. He took over the set piece deliveries in that game for the Red Bulls. And Jesse Marsh said publicly, that may be the way we go from now on. He's giving Kljestan a tryout of sorts tonight on set pieces, and Sasha Kljestan doesn't need no tryouts. He's ready to produce right away, and he has from set pieces to set up now 3 goals in the last 2 halves of Red Bull soccer.
And a small mistake from him against the Vancouver Whitecaps, he picked up a red card, a momentary lap, but he has come back from that.
Yes.
And sometimes maybe you need those moments to wake you up. And he said it was a silly mistake. He said it was on him. Adjusting to returning to this league and the way things are done compared to what it was like in Belgium and over in Europe. And now he's come back and he's played probably his best game and a half of soccer in the last 2 months. And so he's returned and, like you said, taking over set pieces, becoming a force. Dax McCarty said he had to be the brain of this team. And he has really taken it upon himself in these 2 New York derbies.
Oh, we're in New Jersey tonight, my friend.
And he, a Seton Hall grad,
yep,
came up playing here in this area, knows how much it means to a lot of the players that are from this area.
Zizo's got a step on that right wing, looking for a bong. It's over his head. Freeman confidently chests it to himself, and volley's clear. Good win there by Miazga. So a minute plus stoppage time away from halftime, and that was a big goal for the Red Bulls, as it would be for any team coming so close to halftime. The Cosmos had maybe a 15-minute stretch where they were on the front foot, but the Red Bulls had been pushing with those offside calls. They get the breakthrough from the Kljestan to Abong connection.
Cosmos grew in confidence after their goal. Like you said, controlled play for a little while. The Red Bulls were able to hold on, get that goal off the set piece, finally getting some production off those opportunities. And we know this Cosmos team will not give up and will not quit. We already mentioned the ability they have on the bench. Adam Moffitt to come off the bench, Raul to come off the bench. Very rarely do you put Raul after Adam Moffitt. But they have ability. They're consistently a team that's come back throughout the season in NASL play as well as in US Open Cup play. And so it's a tough time to give up a goal going into the locker room, but this is a team that has a lot of confidence in their abilities.
Adam Moffitt first, Raul second. The record show that was David Gass, G-A-S-S. You can let him know what you think of that.
I was channeling my inner Yardley.
Yeah.
Of course.
We're into 1 minute of first half stoppage time. The Red Bulls 2, the Cosmos 1. Zizo plays it in, falls to Lloyd Sam, looking for 3, and Danny Zatella slowed him down. Back to Kljestan, now McCarty.
Sam forcing it back to his right foot there. He had space on his left. He was willing to take it. Zatella in the perfect position.
Chris Duvall off the throw-in. Marco Senna will bang it to midfield. That's going to do it on the first 45 minutes in Harrison, New Jersey. And what a 45 minutes it was. The New York Red Bulls jumped on top. The New York Cosmos came right back. And then at the end of the first half, Anatole Abong put the Red Bulls back in front. David, last thoughts on the first 45.
I think Jesse Marsh goes into the locker room and says that he's happy with what he saw, but they have to bring a high level of energy. They can't drop off like they did in the first half after they scored. And for Coach Savarese, it's more of what you saw. They played well. They created opportunities. Restrepo can be a bit more productive with his crosses, but they're getting opportunities down the wing. They just have to keep their head level, not lose marks on those set pieces. And we're in for an exciting second half.
We are. We'll take about a 10-minute break, come back with first half highlights and that second half. The Red Bulls 2, the Cosmos 1 in the Open Cup. We've got a good one from New Jersey. Back here at Red Bull Arena, Lamar Hunt U.S. Open Cup round of 16. Red Bulls in white, Cosmos in blue. Didn't take the Red Bulls long to get in front. The fifth minute, Lloyd Sam to Sal Zizo with the header. And David, just like last year when the Cosmos, the home team, jumped out on top early, the Red Bulls stunning the Cosmos early.
Lloyd Sam has come in off an injury and has looked extremely sharp. Every time New York Red Bulls go down that right wing, they're able to create something dangerous. Hunter Freeman falls asleep a little bit on his man, and then the header is buried perfectly. And this goal, it started from a turnover from Duval, but Jimmy Maurer's pass for a goalkeeper to curl it up that wing. Restrepo's been dangerous all game when he's been running at his man, and you can call it lucky. You don't have to. I wouldn't, because it might be a little cheesy, but Cosmos had a great mentality to get themselves back into this game. They dominated at times, not dominated, but controlled the ball very well at times in that first half. But right at the end, Anatole Abang here, able to fight off Hunter Freeman, goes up over him, the 18-year-old. A great athlete, has that good natural size, and he's able to bury that one into the net and really give this New York Red Bulls team the perfect boost going into the locker room.
The Cosmos goal that tied it came in the 16th minute, and the Red Bulls going ahead in the 42nd minute, so very shortly before halftime. So the Cosmos going to have to respond as they did in that second half of their fourth round game against New York City FC. One way they have responded straight off the bat is to bring in the big gun. Raul in off the bench, replacing Andres Flores at halftime. Giovanni Savarese, got an ace in your pocket, you better play it. Down a goal at halftime, does so here. The winner of this one gets the Philadelphia Union in the Open Cup quarterfinals. Again, if the Red Bulls win, they would host that game. If the Cosmos win, Philadelphia would host that game. And again, date and time, all of that available on ussoccer.com tomorrow morning. We'll be down to 8 teams looking for this year's U.S. Open Cup title, which, as we mentioned earlier, carries a spot in next year's CONCACAF Champions League. Underway in the second half from Red Bull Arena. Bragging rights in the New York metropolitan area on the line. The Red Bulls 2, the Cosmos 1. As we open the second half of this round of 16 game in the Lamar Hunt U.S. Open Cup.
And 3 goals in the first half, attacking play both sides. 2 sets of fan groups chanting back and forth across this stadium. You didn't need anything else, and then you brought in one of arguably the greatest strikers of his generation in Raul to just make your mouth drool just a little bit more. This has been a fun game so far, but we are in for a very good second half.
Chris Duval couldn't connect with a teammate. It rolls to Jimmy Maurer. 9-4 shot advantage for the New York Red Bulls in the first half. Again, goals from Zizo and Abang, putting the Red Bulls in front.
And we saw Flores very quiet in that hole behind Cassano, where Raul's now playing. Expect him to be a lot more influential on this game. They're going to have to find ways to get that player touches more, play through him rather than over the top.
I do want to mention there were 3 yellow cards in the first half. Connor Lade in the 11th minute, Walter Restrepo in the 19th minute. And Hunter Freeman did get one, we've been told, in the 34th minute. We noted the talking to. We didn't see the yellow card, but it is showing up on the statistics from the sideline. So again, a yellow card to Hunter Freeman from the Cosmos back in the 34th minute. So 2 to the Cosmos, 1 to the Red Bulls in the first half. If you're scoring at home, and for those of you who are, we salute you. Scoring at home on an Open Cup evening, not an easy thing.
Yardley salutes you.
You salute them too.
By the way, me and Yardley, an example of how New Jersey and Long Island can get along.
Fernandez, Raul, back and forth, can't connect. So close to the tying goal once again. Leo Fernandez trying to combine with Raul.
And we see Raul's presence already as more of a second forward than we saw from Flores. And so Cassano here battling, and Raul right there to help him out. Leo Fernandez closes the space, that quick 1-2 opening up, allowing that shot to be taken. Cassano has battled well. He's gotten help off the wings, but he didn't get the help from Flores that he's going to get here in the second half with Raul next to him.
Really high boot there, I believe on Abong. Fernandez got taken down, and Ted Uncle elects not to go yellow card, which has Giovanni Savarese curious, to say the least. Connor Lade going forward. Tried to lay it off. Lloyd Sam came in to pick it up. Back to Lloyd Sam. Shoots right to Jimmy Maurer.
And when Lloyd Sam floats over to the far wing, it means that he can cut in and set up on his favored right foot. What you see here with Kleshin laying it off, and we know how dangerous he can be. He started this season extremely dangerous. The goal-scoring form has started to find it again before his injury. Looking to get back there.
This is Raul coming very deep on the field. Sets up Caceres. Floats it forward for Cassano. Miazga was right there. Ball fell to the Cosmos anyway. Now Lade able to clear. Picked off by Caceres in turn. Raul surrounded. He's able to keep the ball eventually. Here's Fernandez. Drives it low with the left foot, right to Luis Robles. No problem for the veteran Red Bulls keeper.
And in about 5 minutes, Raul in that role has had more touches than I think Flores had the entire first half. It's an outlet now that Zitella and Senna didn't have in that first half. And when they're able to turn their defender, they have a player that they know they can safely, if they can get it to his feet, will be able to at least hold the ball, if not create something.
New York Red Bulls leading the New York Cosmos. A Sal Zizzo goal in the fifth minute got the Red Bulls off to the perfect start. Lucky Cassano tied it in the 16th minute. Anatol Abong, the go-ahead goal from a Sasha Kleshin corner in the 42nd minute. And we'll remind you that Raul is in off the bench at halftime of this one. Possibly a game-changing sub for the Cosmos. Big cheer here as Damian Perrinel kept that one in play, but the Red Bulls can't hold it. Still Walter Restrepo down for the Cosmos, out of your picture, but now back on his feet. Duval overlaps Sam. Only Abong in the box. He looks for him, just out of the reach of both the goalkeeper Maurer and the striker Abong, and it comes to nothing.
And I got on Cristobal a little bit in the first half for that early ball. But this time, there are no other options. And Abong is step for step with his defender. And he curls that one in, coming back towards Abong to allow him to at least challenge Jimmy Maurer for that ball. A much better ball, a much better decision there. And when Cristobal turns on the Jets going down that wing, he's a game changer.
Foul whistled against Hunter Freeman on that far side. A reminder, you can follow U.S. Soccer's coverage of the Lamar Hunt U.S. Open Cup on Twitter. At Open Cup for all the scoring updates tonight and the schedule updates tomorrow, when they'll reveal the dates and times for the four quarterfinal games expected to be played later this month.
And with so many games going on across the country, Jeff Crandall does a great job there at Open Cup to give you all that news, to keep you up to speed on all the goals going on around the tournament, especially for some of those rounds when you have 32 games going on at the same time.
Kleschen's delivery headed out by Senna. Through ball from McCarty, finds Lloyd Sam, three in the box. His pass was behind Perenelle. Kleschen slid in on Senna. It is one back by the Red Bulls. Here's Duvall into the penalty area, goes down. Penalty kick coming for the Red Bulls. Chris Duvall drew it, sneaking up on Hunter Gorski.
And we know his speed, but Hunter Gorski turned off mentally for a second while shielding that ball. It gave time for Chris Duvall to run up behind him and win it, and at that point he had to take him down and not let him to go clean in on goal.
Jimmy Maurer saved three penalty kicks in the shootout win over New York City FC 2 weeks ago. He faces Sasha Kleschen here. Kleschen, count it straight up the gut. Red Bulls 3, Cosmos 1. The Red Bulls closing in on area bragging rights.
This New York Red Bulls team has struggled a little bit, finishing from the spot over the last few weeks. Sasha Kleschen, though, chips it right down the middle. Calm and composed from one of your star players. He's been good on set pieces all game, gets himself a goal here. And really, really excited. You see him gesturing to the bench, gesturing to the fans right now. Talking to his team, trying to keep that energy level high now after this goal.
One of the reasons he wanted to come back was the type of leadership role he could take on this team, and you saw some of it there. You were right on it, David. He wasn't satisfied with the goal, celebrating the goal. It was, come on, guys, we still have 35 minutes to play. And it's kind of an evolution of Kleschen, back his first year in MLS after a number of years excelling for Anderlecht in Belgium.
And we can't say it enough times, this Cosmos team was trailing 2-0 in the 64th minute against NYCFC. They were trailing 2-0 on the road against the Carolina Railhawks in the 90th minute, and were still able to come back in that game in NASL play and get a 2-2 tie. Raul scored on the road against Minnesota United FC to tie it up in the 90th minute, 1-1 in that game. This Cosmos team will not quit. They haven't played over the last 2 weeks, so they have plenty of energy. This game means a lot to them. On top of that, they always have that confidence that they have the ability to come back.
Sean Davis with some space, looking for Sam. It was broken up by Danny Zatella. Smart play by Lade. He spotted Sam, who brings it down. Left-footed cross, bicycle attempt, and a bomb can't connect. He beats the ground in frustration with a big fist.
Not scared to try anything, though, the teenager. When you're scoring and playing, confidence comes easy.
Everybody in white and red confident at the moment, and Sean Davis headed over the top. I beg your pardon, that was Zizo on the far side.
He scored a goal with his head earlier in this game. Lloyd Sam, once again, able to give Gorski trouble, uses his left foot on this one. And Anatole Bong, why not take a chance? Could have the goal of the year, or you end up on your back. Well, either way, I guess you end up on your back. But this is going to be a key 5 minutes. Last time, Red Bulls got the goal. They had another chance right after, but then they allowed the Cosmos to get themselves back in the game.
Bad collision near midfield between, I believe, Miazga and Zatella. An unlikely coming together of heads. And Ted Uncle wisely stopping things so both can get some attention.
A couple of U.S. Women's National Team jerseys in the crowd. A good night
as
for them
be.
As well.
Great atmosphere inside Red Bull Arena tonight. Red and white in the South Ward off to our right. And the other end of the stadium, forced upstairs, of course, they are the visitors, the green of New York Cosmos supporters groups. And they are myriad that have made the trip out to New Jersey tonight. Miazga's staying in. Zitella came off because his training staff entered the playing field, but Zitella will check back in shortly. He jogs back in right now, so 11 against 11 right away. This is Zizo on the left. Only had one target in the box, but the cross knocked out for a throw. Giovanni Savarese talking to Sebastian Guenzatti. Likely to be the next substitute for the Cosmos. Gorski to Zitella, and Miazga collides with him once again, wins the ball once again, throw in to the Cosmos.
In the last Open Cup match, Savarese made a move at the exact same time. That time it was bringing Leo Fernandez on, and it was a game changer. It was able to get them their first goal and to swing the momentum in their favor. We'll see if he can do that again here tonight.
This is Restrepo. Senna gets it back to him. Luis Robles read it and ushers it out for a goal kick. And Restrepo came down awkwardly behind the goal. The Cosmos were readying a substitution anyway, but for a different player. And we'll see if they adjust their tact based on Walter Restrepo going down. New York Red Bulls return home in MLS action on Saturday, July 11th, 7 o'clock, as the Eastern Conference second place team right now, the New England Revolution, come to Red Bull Arena. For tickets and more information, log on to newyorkredbulls.com or call 1-877-727-6223. Today, the Red Bulls and the Revs, July 11th at Red Bull Arena. Restrepo is back on his feet, not yet back on the field. He's going to try to re-enter on the far side as his Cosmos defend with 10 players.
Almost a mistake there from Jimmy Maurer, hanging on to the ball a little bit too long. We know Jesse Marsh's team likes to play their high press style, but it's gone off and on in this game, and when they've turned it on, the Cosmos have been caught off guard, like on that penalty kick that Gorski gave up.
The Restrepo back in, and the Cosmos will make the original plan sub. Leo Fernandez comes out here in the 62nd minute. And Sebastian Guenzatti comes on, 23-year-old in his third pro season from Queens, born in Uruguay but raised in Queens.
And another local product for this game. Leo Fernandez going off, grew up on Long Island as well.
Can't have too many in a game like this.
Leo Fernandez from North Babylon, where Danny Green as well, the NBA player, is from. And speaking of the NBA, Carmelo Anthony is in the house today. The newest owner of an NASL franchise, and he's here to take in this New York Derby, as you'd call it.
As you would call it. We tried to get an exclusive interview as this one's hit off the crossbar and the rebound hits the post as well, and it just won't go in for the Cosmos. Oh, so close to making it a one-goal game.
And you see it all there on the face of Raul. It looked like the perfect moment to swing the momentum of this game. Banged off the crossbar. Cassana in the perfect position, strikes it well, and it hits off the post. Cosmos, you just got to hope it's not one of those nights for them.
That's the last Carmelo Anthony reference we're going to make, because it apparently leads to chaos in the penalty area.
Makes me happy.
Chris Duvall, slow to get up for the Red Bulls. Had a lot of those over the last 5 to 10 minutes or so. Players chipping away at each other on each side, but Duvall apparently okay.
And you got to say, this is the time. Now, this is the third straight midweek game for the New York Red Bulls. They played an intense game in front of a big crowd on Sunday against NYCFC. So now as we're starting to hit that 65th, 70th minute, this is where you might see those heavy legs. You might see players not making that extra effort. We've seen Chris Duvall work so hard in this game. But these players have put in a lot of minutes over the last few weeks, and this is where the Cosmos have the advantage in coming off that rest.
Red Bulls are set to make their first substitution, and Mike Grella will be checking in. Spends plenty of time in the starting lineup for the Red Bulls. 13 MLS starts, 4 MLS goals this year for the Red Bulls.
There seems to be some confusion between who the fourth official is trying to put up and who Jesse Marsh actually wanted to take out.
So it is Lloyd Sam coming out after conferring with the official substitution card. Mike Grella coming in the 65th minute. You wanted New York products? We bring you Glen Cove's own Mike Grella.
And I think for Lloyd Sam, a great return from injury. Looked sharp, was dangerous, crossing from the right side as well as cutting in, as we've seen him do more this season than he's done in his entire New York Red Bulls career. Linking up with the forwards, linking up with Kleshchen. A good game from him. And Mike Grella needed that little bit of rest. I don't know if he had the energy in him for another start, but he is a player who's creative, who takes defenders on when he can, and is dangerous as a starter and will be very dangerous off the bench.
Cosmos continue to be dangerous. This is Restrepo. Damian Perenelle two-footed, but he won the ball and comes away with it for the Red Bulls.
And I think the hearts and a couple mouths of Red Bulls staff and fans there. Perenelle couldn't lose that tackle. Went in, as you said, two-footed in his own box, but able to get it clean, and our head referee right on the spot to make that call.
66th minute, Sasha Kleshchen's second half penalty kick won by Chris Duvall has given the Red Bulls a bit of a cushion, but again, as the Cosmos have shown just 2 weeks ago in this tournament, no lead is safe until the whistle blows. They'll have a free kick here on the right. Hunter Freeman, so influential in that comeback 2 weeks ago, lining it up.
Red Bulls got a goal off of a set piece to close that first half. It would be big for the Cosmos to get one here.
Freeman's delivery runs through everybody and is tracked down by Restrepo. Plays it in low. Red Bulls clear it, but only as far as Itella. He wants the spectacular, and he didn't miss it by all that much.
Sat up clean for him. You can see Zatella maybe taking a couple lessons from his midfield partner, Marco Senna. Hits that one well, gets it to dip. Just couldn't get it on frame. It's sets up perfectly for Zitella. We know throughout his U.S. youth international as well as full international career, his ability to score goals. Play Michael Bradley-esque out of the midfield. Late runs into the box as well as shots from outside.
There's a good touch for Grella trying to connect with Abong. The veteran Carlos Mendes all over him and wins a throw-in for the Cosmos.
And that's a job well done from Abong anyways. Team leading 3-1. Continue to battle. Make it hard for the opposing center backs. Allow your team a couple moments of rest when you can. It's part of the development of a center forward. That game management now that Anatole Abong still is learning.
Davis collides with his teammate, Grella. And Ted Uncle explains, hey, that guy's in white. I can't call a foul on him. Saw Jesse Marsh with the hands, tried to keep that moving quickly, even with his team up two goals.
Yeah,
but
that was interesting.
The ball
to
turned
see.
Over.
Clearly, we know how the Red Bulls are going to play this, if that's how their coach is going to play it himself.
Yeah, full marks to Jesse Marsh for that. And again, this is a lineup that he would be comfortable putting out in an MLS game, and it has done them a world of good, up 3-1 right now. Obviously, the full test of that will come Saturday when you see how the minutes wear on a guy like McCarty, on a guy like Kleshchen, who has to cover a lot of ground. So far, they've been up to the heavy minutes logged this season. Marco Senna snuck in to win that one. Get it to Restrepo. Kleshchen chasing him. And Restrepo lost his footing, and that allowed Dax McCarty to come away with it.
Restrepo on ice all of a sudden. But since the substitution, Restrepo's gone out left. So Lade had gotten comfortable defending him a little bit. Now a new look for Cristoval with Restrepo and his tendency to try and take his defender on one-on-one, put them on their heels here now on this left wing.
Now it's his second time going down. The Cosmos have only one substitution remaining, and I believe they're going to use it on Hagop Chirishian. Reminder, you still have time to vote for your favorite New York Red Bulls player for the 2015 AT&T MLS All-Star Game. Voting is open now, ends on July 3rd, so you better get moving quickly. Go to NewYorkRedBulls.com or MLSsoccer.com today to vote.
And Restrepo's been fantastic this game offensively. He created the only goal of the game so far for the Cosmos. A lot of their best attacking players come through him. Unfortunate to see him forced out of this game with an injury. Two-time NASL Best 11 player.
And this is the go-ahead goal right now, the game winner. Anatole Abong just before halftime heading in a Sasha Kleshchen corner.
And you're starting to see a youth movement here at the New York Red Bulls, both homegrown players as well as young players that they've been able to bring in from around the world. They're becoming a major factor in this team. A little bit of a change of identity for this club that has taken on pretty well so far in the first season.
Cosmos with 10 at the moment as Chirishian has not yet checked in. Marco Senna, great footwork to turn out of trouble. Classy touch by Raul. He gets the ball back and he gets fouled right in the middle of the field. Dax McCarty apoplectic that Ted Uncle fell for what I think he thinks was a bit of sandbagging. And now Chirishian allowed in the 72nd minute. Again, replacing Restrepo, who already left injured. Dangerous spot here. And again, if the Cosmos can strike from a free kick, make it a one-goal game, we could have a heck of a finish at Red Bull Arena.
And you'd be surprised if Marco Senna doesn't try and take a shot here.
Marco Senna over the wall, and Luis Robles had to punch it away. He had to adjust to a new angle and handled it for the Red Bulls.
And Senna here almost tricks Robles. It goes up over the wall but curls back to that left-hand post. Robles able to plant his foot, dive back, and push it wide. A well-taken set piece, though, for Marcus Senna.
Yeah, I couldn't tell if it took a deflection off the wall or if it was just the delivery, but Robles was going to his left and had to go back to his right. It's a handball called, and it'll be a free kick for the Red Bulls, who now will waste just a bit of time. 18 minutes plus stoppage time away from a quarterfinal date with the Philadelphia Union.
And I never want to count the cardiac Cosmos out, but you got to think they got to get that second goal in the next 8-9 minutes to give them some time to pour the pressure on and potentially push this game to extra time.
Question was tackled late. Zatella is furious at what he thinks is a bit of acting. And Ted Uncle is going to have a word with Zatella.
Danny Zatella, Dax McCarty, played in that 2008 Olympics team together and seemed to be getting along really well in that sequence. But Danny Zatella is a guy who's always brought fire to the game. It's been part of what he does, and it's been good to see him come back in his professional career and get to these heights again.
Abong bravely stooped to try and head that one. Took a boot to the head in the process.
Took about 20, 30 seconds for him to figure out he got kicked in the head.
Definitely a delayed reaction. And now Perenel and Caceres, really for minimal reason, clashing as Perenel, he says, goes to check on his fallen teammate.
And Caceres not happy, but one of the things to point out is Anatole Abong does not speak English.
Perenel is the translator in this case.
So I think that's why he's coming over to see if he needs the trainer. Him and Sasha Kleshtin, two of the players fluent in French and English on this squad. And I think he's trying to explain that now to the referee, Perenel is, to
and
Uncle.
Now he's being called back for more translation.
Jimmy Maurer trying to speed this up. Hasn't had a lot of work to do in this game. Unfortunately for him, hasn't been able to get a hand to the three goals, but showed flashes of the quality that he has. Chris Duvall starting to turn a corner as a player and really become a major part of this team.
This is Sasha Kleshtin's penalty kick, the 54th minute. Straight up the gut, and yes, celebrate in the South Ward for Sasha Kleshtin.
And you got to have composure. You have to have confidence to take that shot. Believe that your team, even if something does go wrong, will back you up. We saw Bradley Wright Phillips miss two opportunities in one game just 2 weeks ago here in this building. Sasha Kleshtin now going off to a heavy applause.
He assisted the go-ahead goal, scored the insurance goal, and he makes way for Felipe. We told you Felipe had started every game this year until now. He's going to be a part of it, coming on in place of Kleshtin. He and Davis still trying to figure out their positioning. Anatole Abong, meanwhile, back on the field. We are full strength, 11 against 11 here. It's a bit of a lighter moment during that delay. Giovanni Savarese and Jesse Marsh were arguing their respective points with the fourth official, and to prove there were no hard feelings, had a quick handshake in-game. Of course, they'll share one afterward as well.
Savarese, who's meant everything to the game in this area.
Great run by Felipe. Top of the box. Maurer punched it out well. He's still out of goal as the Red Bulls try and capitalize.
And not the first time in this game we've seen Maurer play that sweeper-keeper role well and come out and make a big play in the open field.
Grella slaloming at the Cosmos defense. Taken down for a free kick. Cosmos hands in the air in protest. But it will be a free kick for the Red Bulls.
And Lloyd Sam, while he's a good attacking player, Mike Grella has this ability to put defenders on their heels, make them uncomfortable, keep the ball close to his foot, similar to what we saw from Restrepo throughout this game. It's going to be dangerous here late in the game as he's able to draw opportunities like this for his team. And now with Kleshtin out, Felipe stepping up on the set piece.
Felipe Felipe plays Zizo. He is onside in the penalty area. Chipping it. Headed over the top by Miazga.
And Raul has reason to complain right now. Dax McCarty held his jersey as he came off the wall to try and chase that through ball. You'll see here at the start of this play, Raul looks to chase McCarty, the sneaky pull on the jersey there, able to allow Zizo the open space to dribble into, and he's not happy with the fourth official there.
Not sure when the Red Bulls had time to put in all these free kicks with all the games they've been playing. A couple of them have created dangerous looks tonight.
Just draw them up in the dirt with a stick.
Mendes at the back for the Cosmos. Again, they've used all three substitutions, so no more changes at the disposal of Savarese. But Hunter Freeman is pushing much, much higher than he was earlier in the game. Gorski back to Mendes. Cosmos will be in action Sunday, hosting Indy 11 at Schuert Stadium on Long Island at Hofstra University. The Red Bulls will be back in action Saturday night at the Columbus Crew, 7:30 p.m. kickoff. You can see that one in the New York area on MSG. Zatella back to Raul, trying to move the ball quickly. Sean Davis able to break it up.
And Cassano was so active in the first half, getting a lot of touches, involved in the play, and he hasn't really gotten any looks here in the second.
Zizo behind Felipe with Grella lurking, but easily broken up by Hunter Gorski for the Cosmos. Long ball here, and he kept it in play. Guenzotti plays it in low, and it's not close enough to Cassana. Matt Miazga able to clear. Guenzotti was onside. There was a trailing defender on the opposite side of the field that kept him on. Cosmos up against it here. 10 minutes plus stoppage time remaining at Red Bull Arena. Last year, the Cosmos were eliminated from the Open Cup on the road by the Philadelphia Union. But it was a much different game. The Cosmos lost on an overtime penalty kick. They felt hard done by. Tonight, they can't have any complaints. The Red Bulls have earned their goals. The Cosmos did hit two posts a minute ago, so they've had their chances. But full strength for both sides, and probably right now a scoreline reflecting that.
And it was an even back and forth first half, but it's been the Red Bulls who have controlled this second half. You said those two posts hit by the Cosmos. A lot of that has been on the counterattack, more against the run of play. Red Bulls have been able to create
stadium anytime recently, and I would imagine they are sold out or close to it again tonight.
And the home teams have been successful so far throughout this round.
Home teams determined by random draw, except in cases where a team did not bid or was unable to meet the hosting requirements of that round. That turnover fell to Marco Senna, but he couldn't keep possession. McCarty starts it the other way. Here's Zizo. Grella and Abong running inside of him, 3-on-3. Zizo trying to put it away. Grella keeps it alive. What a stop by Maurer. He denied Felipe and keeps it a two-goal game. That's the save of the night.
A highlight save from Jimmy Maurer coming back across the goal. A little bit too much from the Red Bulls, as if they're trying to walk it in. The initial cross, Grella maybe too composed this time, cuts it back, and Jimmy Maurer full extension and punching it wide. What a save from him.
Oh, bad tackle. Duvall and Gorski, they both went into it hard, but Duvall got the worst of it. Duvall was red carded in this game last year. I didn't see any malice in that one, to be quite honest.
Stretched in to get there.
At first glance, I didn't see malice on either side. So for me, yellow card to Gorski, probably the right call. Just at first look, which of course is all Ted Uncle gets as well.
Gorski, another one of the New Jersey natives here in this game. Come back, played heavy minutes throughout his time with the New York Cosmos. trialing a little bit with the Earthquakes. Fortunately, I think one of the losses for this Cosmos team, without Iose on the at left back, Gorski, they've lost from center back. They've also lost the attacking ability of Iose up that wing, who's so creative for this team, who's so dangerous whipping balls in. And you've seen less of a balanced attack in this game. Hunter Freeman and Restrepo most of this game giving you something dangerous down the right side and nothing really down the left side to return that.
And this is not looking good for Chris Duvall. They are going to stretcher him off, looking very seriously at that leg. Guy who just scored the biggest goal of his life on Sunday in the win over New York City FC. And you feel for Chris Duvall.
And drew a penalty kick in this game has been a huge factor here in the second half. When you talk about that high press game, his speed is a ace up the sleeve for this New York Red Bulls team, consistently attacking up the right side.
You saw Anthony Wallace turning in the substitution card, 26-year-old in his first season with the Red Bulls. Has seen time both with the first team, that one game at Columbus, and with Red Bulls too. And he played in the NASL last year with Tampa Bay, one of the big rivals of the Cosmos, the Rowdies. And he is going to come on here for Chris Duvall, but that's really the primary concern now for the Red Bulls. Beyond just what it means for Duvall and any recovery time that he might have, David, outside back is not the Red Bulls' deepest spot right now because of the Gold Cup. Roy Miller and Kemar Lawrence both away with national teams. And so Wallace may have been getting minutes anyway. Certainly Connor Lade was expected to, and now they are both going to be in at the same time in this one.
The Red Bulls knew the next few weeks were going to be some time that they had to manage their roster. This doesn't make it any easier. They lost Lloyd Sam to an injury in their last U.S. Open Cup match. And now it looks like losing Chris Duvall here in the 85th minute.
And it's a risk you take in any game. Sometimes feels worse when it happens in an Open Cup, but it's always a risk, whether it's practice or a game. As we look back at some of the best saves of the night coming in this second half, Luis Robles having to switch sides and deny that Marco Senna free kick.
And Jimmy Maurer, we saw a highlight reel save, and he's a guy who trialed around in MLS.
And Chris Duvall leads to a round of applause. Our thoughts go with him for a speedy recovery, and a scary sight for everybody to see Chris Duvall leave the field. It does mean Anthony Wallace takes the field here in the 87th minute.
Wallace going to left back, so Connor Lade will switch sides and move to his more natural right back position.
And it's unfortunate. That's going to be maybe the biggest takeaway from the game, rather than the score and the rivalry and what was, to me, a great night in terms of fans and the atmosphere at Red Bull Arena. Unfortunately, most unfortunately for Chris Duvall, that's going to be a big loss for the Red Bulls for however long they're without him. Second year right back Duvall out of Wake Forest. And our thoughts to him tonight. So we'll have a lot of stoppage time based on that. 2 minutes plus left in regulation. Again, Ted Uncle will add on the appropriate amount of stoppage time as the Cosmos try to pull something out of their sleeves.
And it's been interesting in this game since Felipe's come on for Question that he's moved forward and Sean Davis has stayed in that holding midfield role. Good to see Jesse Marsh trusting the young player in such a big game with this lead in that defensive midfield role.
Really good touch by Zizo there to keep possession. He returns the ball to Felipe and Caceres able to knock it up and out for a throw-in. One of the interesting things with Davis is the Red Bulls obviously prefer him to Dan Metzger, who's with the Red Bulls 2 team. Metzger keeps getting called into the Olympic squad, and Sean Davis doesn't. and they're both age eligible. And Jesse Marsh has repeatedly said, without being belligerent about it, he thinks Sean Davis deserves a look as well. And these first team minutes, one way for him to prove that.
Yeah, luxury the Olympic and youth teams have now. The amount of professional lower division teams in the U.S. to see players play first team minutes.
Felipe to Grella, onto his left, back to his right. Puts it away, Mike Grella from Long Island. Paints Long Island, New York, and New Jersey red tonight.
And this is what he has brought for this New York Red Bulls team the entire season. Willing to take risks, to attack his defenders. He has gotten more and more confident as a finisher. The Duke University alumni coming back from Europe, like you said, grew up just a few minutes from Hofstra Stadium, where the Cosmos now play their games, and puts the nail in the coffin on this one for the Red Bulls.
A year ago, it was Cosmos 3, Red Bulls nothing at Schuert Stadium. In 2015, it is Red Bulls 4, Cosmos 1 at Red Bull Arena. We're into stoppage time now. We're told 5 minutes of it coming.
And the mentality for this New York Red Bulls team. Coming off the first goal, dropped off a little bit, allowed the Cosmos back in the game to get the goal, to control pace. And we saw it. We said Jesse Marsh grabbing that ball and getting his team back in. Up 3-1, they continued to push. They didn't sit back and defend. It didn't allow the Cosmos any opportunities, really, to get back into the game. And then finally putting the nail in the coffin. This is a Red Bulls team that's going to continue to push and going to continue to attack under Jesse Marsh, and tonight it's been successful.
Raul on the run for the Cosmos, broken up by Anthony Wallace for the Red Bulls. We're into the second minute of stoppage time. We'll have five. The Red Bulls are going to play the Philadelphia Union in the U.S. Open Cup quarterfinals. Date, site, kickoff time, all to be announced tomorrow by U.S. Soccer. As the Red Bulls look for one more, here's Zizo. After a bong was taken down, back outside for Grella. And he's content to just keep possession.
And the New York Red Bulls have never won this competition. They went to the final in 2003, losing at home. Since that, they've not won two games in one cup. They've not gotten past two rounds. Jesse Marsh promised he would take this tournament seriously. He said that this team needs to win trophies. They can't miss any opportunity to do that. He's come with two strong lineups in his opening two U.S. Open Cup games, and he's going to get those two victories, and hopefully for him and for the Red Bulls, push even farther past the Philadelphia Union.
Well, they'll get another team that takes the tournament very seriously. Jim Curtin and the Union play their starters in this tournament going back to last year when they made a run to the final. Jim Curtin, another player who came through Chicago, just like Jesse Marsh, where we know they're big fans of the Open Cup, kind of drilled into them. And given that the Union got a win in this building, Red Bull Arena, back in May in the regular season, very curious to see a second meeting in the Open Cup later this year. They're also scheduled to play in the regular season on August 1st. I don't think they're just going to decide to have that game count as both. I don't think that's how we roll anymore.
No, we're seeing it in the California Clasico twice in 1 week. These teams don't need any more reason for animosity or pressure in their rivalry, but we give them that anyway. And like you said, the understanding of this cup competition on the New York Red Bulls bench, you have Jesse Marsh, Chris Armas, Dennis Hamlett, all guys who have won this trophy. John Wolanek in their career numerous times for a few of them. And so they know what it takes to win. They know what it means for a club and for a franchise to win a trophy like this.
Well, the first chant that went up was, "This is our house," which the Red Bulls have most certainly defended tonight. I believe the second was, "Beat the traffic," which seems fruitless in any event.
Spoken like a true commuter.
Just from my experience driving here today. Gorski's cross floats on Robles, who will catch easily. We've had about 4 minutes of the 5 minutes of stoppage time. On a night of four-star entertainment for the Red Bulls, Sal Zizo, Anatole Bong, Sasha Kleshchen, and Mike Grella with the goals. The Cosmos were in it for a while and kept threatening in the second half. But they're going to come up short on the road against an MLS team for the second straight year.
And we have to say, for two guys who grew up in this area, to see the amount of quality teams now, competition, the fan groups that are in this tri-state area, the opportunity to watch them go up against each other, to feel the energy, it's no matter what the result, it was always going to be a special night, and it's shown to be that so far. We know now whenever these teams match up, we're going to get goals. That one's for sure.
Again, the Cosmos back in action Sunday, hosting Indy 11. The Red Bulls on the road against Columbus on Saturday, home against New England on July 11th. Can the Red Bulls make it five? Gorella can't come up with that one. Four is good enough. The New York Red Bulls take revenge, take it emphatically, and take bragging rights in the New York metropolitan area with them. In the U.S. Open Cup, Red Bulls 4, Cosmos 1. The final from New Jersey tonight. Great time bringing this one to you as Jesse Marsh, Giovanni Savarese, and the staff from both teams enter the field. The Red Bulls and the Philadelphia Union will meet in the quarterfinals. That date is to be announced. Stay tuned to USsoccer.com and the team websites as we look back, David Goss, at how this one happened. The Red Bulls jumped on the Cosmos early. This is the fifth minute Sal Zizo striking.
The Cosmos coming off a long break. The Red Bulls, heavy games right now. You thought maybe they'd come out the sharper team, and they proved it here on this opening goal. Lloyd Sam coming back from injury floats this ball up and makes it an easy finish. Gives the opportunity for that finish. The Cosmos responded well. They're a team that believes in themselves. They've come back so many times this season. They showed so well for themselves in this game. Jimmy Maurer, who it's going to be hard done giving up four goals after some of the amazing plays he made in this game, none more so than this pass. Restrepo, I thought, was the most dangerous player in the game for the Cosmos. And then that finish there to make it 1-1, but Anatole Bong, a dagger right at the end of the first half to get this goal, and a great moment for this New York Red Bulls team to go into the locker room up 2-1.
That was a momentum provider. Anatole Bong has played for New York Red Bulls too much of the year. He's turned that production into the first team now. Three goals and an assist in the last five games as the Red Bulls target forward. That made it 2-1 going into halftime. In the second half, Chris Duvall drew a penalty kick. Sasha Kleshchen converted it, and the Red Bulls kept the pressure on.
And John, I tell you, for the second straight game, the second half mentality and effort for the New York Red Bulls has been phenomenal. They did it over the weekend against NYCFC, coming out of the locker room on fire, and they did it again here today. Jesse Marsh's boys keeping confidence, pushing teams later in the game. Mike Grella coming off the bench, started the season so hot. Hunter Gorski gets put on his skates and finishes it calmly past Jimmy Maurer to make it an all Red Bulls night.
4-1 the final. Mike Grella icing on the cake, taking Hunter Gorski to school and bearing this one off the post. Glen Cove native takes down the Cosmos with the finishing capper on a 4-1 win for the New York Red Bulls. They're back home at Red Bull Arena in MLS action Saturday, July 11th. 7 o'clock kick as the New England Revolution come to town. For tickets and more information, log on to NewYorkRedBulls.com. or call 1-877-727-6223. That's going to do it for us from Red Bull Arena. Thank you so much for tuning in. We had a blast bringing it to you. For everybody involved in this one, for the great supporters from both sides that made it such a fun game to watch and to listen to, thanks for tuning in tonight to this production of the Lamar Hunt U.S. Open Cup Round of 16. For my partner, David Goss, I'm Jonathan Yardley. The Red Bulls 4, the Cosmos 1, wherever you are in the tri-state area. New Jersey, New York, Long Island, wherever you are, it's red tonight. Red Bulls take down New York City FC on Sunday. They take down the Cosmos on Wednesday. Red Bulls 4, Cosmos 1, the final. Red Bulls on to the quarterfinals.